by the earth. This is her body. By the earth, mother of us all. By the earth, future and past, the circle is cast. Circled is cast by the air. This is her breath. By the air, sweet wind of life. By the air, from the first to the last, the circle is cast.
Good evening and welcome to Sacred Circle. Merry meet everyone. My name is Cate Dalton. This is my husband Frank Dalton. And this evening we have a special guest with us. This is Ainsley Friedberg from Avalon in Norwalk. And this evening we're going to be discussing knowledge, the quest for knowledge, and where we can go in seeking knowledge of our different paths and traditions. Our setup tonight is going to be a little bit different. Usually there's a talk segment right here, but we're going to go right into our ritual. So what I want you to do is just take a look at your screen and keep an eye on these local pagan resources. Thank you.
Hi there. It's nice to be back. We want to explain that the way that Frank and I do circle is a little bit different. So we're going to start your learning curve off with a real bang. Our circle is very simple this evening, and the focus will be on education, knowledge, and wisdom. We cast this circle in love and in light, creating a sacred space, time out of time, where all things meet their equal in opposite and balance.
May this circle be a beacon to others who look to learn and seek knowledge. May the knowledge gained here go forward like ripples in a pond, touching the lives that we all come in contact with.
May this circle surround us and aid us in our quest for knowledge. So mote it be.
So mote it be.
Frank, would you like to call north, please?
Okay, go to north. Powers of the North, we ask that you join us in our working here this evening, and that you lend us the strength to make our foundation strong, so that we can go on and learn the things that are coming forward. Join us in the circle this evening and lend your strength to that foundation.
Elemental beings of air, we ask that you join us here tonight, bringing us powers of mental communication on our quest for knowledge. Be as a breath of fresh air, cleaning away outmoded and outdated misconceptions. Join us this evening.
Powers in the South, land of the dragon, we ask that you light our paths so that we can find the knowledge we seek. Light it with the flame of your breath and keep us safe within your coils as we go forward down this path of knowledge and learning.
Regents of the West, flow forth. Bring from your watery realms the gifts of the peace, love, and intuition we need with which to grow and learn. Grant us the strength of the ocean waters, the waters of the rain, and the mother, the great mother of the oceans. Be here now, so mote it be. We call upon the elemental being of spirit. Spirit, join us here this evening, giving us balance, giving us transformation, helping us to grow and learn, keeping us together, centered, and grounded as we do so. May our path be clear. Great Lady, we ask that you join us and grant us your blessing on our quest for knowledge. Help our feet find the path which we seek, that which is right for us, whether we know it or not. Help us explore the side roads, knowing that we can come back home full of knowledge, full of joy in the learning, and blessed by the companions we meet along the way.
Ancient gods, we ask that you watch over us as we venture forward on all these paths and guide us back home to our strength and our foundations. But let us expand those strength and foundations through the learning gained as we walk through your wonders.
That is our circle for this evening. The rest of the working we're going to do as we speak, hoping that you will learn from what we import to you. We're going to be speaking about Craftwise, which just happened in April at the Danbury Hilton. We're going to be talking about Craftwise in the Woods, which is going to be happening very soon in July. We're going to be speaking about a healing event called Caduceus, which is going to be happening down in New Jersey, where people can learn about methods of healing and how to heal and improve their own techniques. And we're also going to be speaking about some of the classes that are available in some of the local stores, like Avalon in South Norwalk. There's also a very exciting development, and that's going to be, we're going to be talking about that very soon. Sorry. this development is the opening of a pagan community center, where all kinds of fun and exciting things are going to be happening. So if you'll give us a few minutes to get back to our seats, then we'll be with you very shortly. Blessed be.
Welcome back to Sacred Circle. I'm sure that a few of you who have been watching this evening saw what looked like a very short circle. Well, we kind of like it short, sweet, and to the point. We can get real flowery and we can have all the trappings and put all kinds of stuff on the altar, but it really is what comes from here that counts, and we found that out along the way. What we'd like to do now is go to a videotape that was done at Craftwise, and I believe it's a videotape of the vending room. Do we have that tape available? as you can see, we had quite a variety of folks from across the country bringing their wares for sale and to display for everyone. If you couldn't find it there, I don't know if it was ever available. We were sitting here just now watching the tape with you, and Frank and Ainsley and I were all saying that there was a whole bunch of stuff there that we didn't get to see either. So as you can see, there's a whole lot of things out there available for people to learn with and from. One of the things that we'd like to do is start talking about that learning. And Ainsley, you're on.
I'm on?
Yep.
Okay.
Where are you from? Tell us about your store.
Well, I have a store in South Norwalk called Avalon. It's a New Age store, but it specializes in paganism and Wicca. We do classes there. We've had several very well-known authors there speaking. On a regular basis, we teach Wicca 101, which is a series of six classes, and you can call the store for more information. The number there is 203-838-5928. Anything more?
Yeah. What's going on with the Pagan Community Center?
Okay.
That's a real exciting development for the community.
Okay. I'm also the president of the Connecticut Wiccan and Pagan Network, which is based out of Norwalk, Connecticut, but we have representatives all over the southern and western part of the state. We have recently agreed to rent a specific spot in South Norwalk every Sunday. So every Sunday starting on June 7th, and you can contact the store for more information. It is in South Norwalk. We will be having a Sunday pagan brunch, which will be potluck at 11 o'clock every Sunday morning. The afternoons will be free, and it's a really nice area to shop in, so if people want to make a day of it, that's fine. And then in the evenings we will be having, well, the first opening night we're just having a rip-roaring party, but after that we'll be having discussion groups. We may be sponsoring well-known authors, which we've had in the past. Basically, you know, whatever we can get people to volunteer to do, or, you know, people may be interested in.
That sounds like a really great idea, and there's some real good opportunities for contacts. Now, during the break, you were also talking about being in contact with some students from University of Connecticut. For those of you who weren't at CraftWise, we were very excited because the students from the University of Connecticut have formed their own pagan group. It's the Pagans for Diverse Spirituality. And they're a wonderful organization. They're a terrific bunch of young people. And we're very, very excited. One of the wonderful things that happened is a number of other college students happened to be there, and they're all going to be going back talking to folks at their colleges to tell them how to start this organization. So we're going to have this kind of thing springing up across the country, it looks like. They've been very, very active, and they had an absolutely wonderful time, made some terrific connections with some teachers and speakers. Now, you've also been in contact with them.
Yes. We haven't really made any definite plans. It's, you know, we've reciprocated on each other's websites type of thing. I've kept in touch with some of the kids that live locally to me, and they pop in the store every once in a while. They've also been in touch with our New London area coordinator, whose name is Tinker, and she does a monthly event in her area. So if people want to know about monthly events that the CWPN holds in their areas, they can access our website, which I know Bill had thrown on the resources that he listed. If other people want to find out, I guess they can call later. I'd be happy to give them the website address.
That's terrific. How did you start learning?
About Wicca?
Yeah.
Oh my goodness. I was always, as far as I can remember, involved with things hidden, unseen, the occult. And I had been dedicated into a Golden Dawn group at the age of 15. Wasn't really happy with it. It wasn't really my thing. I can't say there was anything wrong with them. It just wasn't for me. And 3 years later, I found a newsletter put out by a special interest group in Mensa, which described Wicca, and I had the feeling that, oh my God, there's other people like me who think like I do and do what I do, and there's a name for it, it's called Wicca, and I'm not the only one in the world. And for me, it was what we call the coming home experience, which is fairly common, you know, within the Wiccan community, that many people, when they find it something they've always believed, they just never had a word to put to it, or any kind of name to call themselves.
Now, for our experience, Frank, I'm going to ask you to talk a little bit about your background.
It's the coming home experience is a good way to explain it. I had been doing certain things the way we usually do things, like you saw here, for years, and then happened to walk into a shop in Fairfield, picked up a book and met the owners, and it was like, oh, okay, there is a name to all this, and we're actually doing something that's been around for years, and it just felt right, and we've gone
We've had the wonderful opportunity to meet more speakers and teachers through the conference, through CraftWise, through some other different things we've been involved with, and it's been a real neat learning experience. Cate and I had worked side by side for years unknowingly because it wasn't something that you brought up and talked about all the time. We just did it, and then all of a sudden we got together and actually did ceremonies together, and it really became a neat thing.
One of the very interesting things is that Frank and myself had one of our first forays into the local pagan community through Ainsley and her store Avalon when it was in Monroe. It was a wonderful experience. We had a great time, met some really terrific people, had a lot of fun, branched out, went off and met a whole bunch of other people. And in doing so, we were introduced to a number of people who were putting together a conference that they called Craft Call. And out of Craft Call has come CraftWise. Its focus is on learning and knowledge, on exchange of knowledge between people of different traditions. So if you're interested in Celtic, but you really only ever work Egyptian, CraftWise is the place to come, because we have people who work Celtic magic, Strega Nona, who has been on the program here before. Lori Bruno is part of the Italian tradition. We have people who follow the Norse tradition, the African Arsha tradition. Pretty much you name it, we look out there and try to find a teacher to come and bring that information to you so that you have that experience. There is another event happening that I would like to touch on a little bit, and that is Caduceus, which is happening down in New Jersey. It's an event that has taken place for the past 2 years. In Pennsylvania, the person who is running it, Reverend Colleen Rose of the Church of Caduceus, has moved it to New Jersey, which is closer to her home base. And she has put together a terrific lineup of health-oriented and healing-oriented speakers, people who do Reiki, people who do crystal healing, herbalists. She tries to get as many people in to do specifically healing as she possibly can. It's going to be a really terrific event, and the information on that, because I have to look for it too, that's going to happen September 4th through the 6th, and it's going to be in Barnegat, New Jersey. You can call for information, and the phone number is area code 732-229-4093, and ask for Reverend Colleen Rose. She is a wonderful person, and hopefully we'll be able to get her up from New Jersey sometime and ask and see if she can come on the show and talk about this herself. It's a really wonderful weekend. It is a camping event. It is not a hotel event. So be prepared, but it will be a whole lot of fun, and we're going to have a really, really good time. The site is beautiful, has a lot of modern amenities, which are very important to most of us who camp, and that's a real good event to go to. Would you like to talk a little bit about CraftWise in the Woods?
CraftWise in the Woods is going to be fun. This is our second year doing an outdoor event. Our strong point had always been the hotel events. And then we got a phone call that there was an opening up at this Brushwood Folklore Center in Sherman, New York last year. So we went up and we talked to the owners, Frank and Darlene Barney, and decided to plan CraftWise in the Woods to have an outdoor event. Because even though we run the hotel conference, a lot of folks were saying, but I don't like to stay in the hotel. I want to actually go and I want to camp. The information at this point is up on the screen, and I'm talking over it, I believe. and it will be a fun weekend. It's July 7th through 12th up at Brushwood in Sherman, New York. It's going to be a really wonderful weekend. We have a lot of things planned. We have surprises in store. There's a bardic night Friday night and a potluck dinner. There'll be a musical concert night Saturday night. And there's a couple surprises planned for during the week. We're not going to let everything out of the bag until you get there. But we're planning on having a lot of fun at this event, and I know there'll be a lot of learning going on up there, too.
We also feature drumming at both the hotel event and at the camping event. The fun thing about the camping event is that it can go all night long, and you can have a really, really good time. There'll also be people available to teach drumming so that you can get started, because I don't know about you, but I'm real intimidated when it comes to drumming. I have a little bit of rhythm, but I'm not real comfortable getting out there and drumming in front of people. So hopefully we'll be able to learn together There's an awful lot of opportunities available in this area for learning and for connecting with teachers and networking with stores. We have found that the stores in the area are one of the best places to connect with folks, one of the best places to network. They are up to date as far as all the groups in the area. They're up to date with all of the events that are happening all summer long. And now it's really the start of the summer season. There's a whole lot of things going on, and we hope that you're going to be involved in a lot of them. It's really to your benefit. I think you'll have a really wonderful time wherever you are. And what we're going to do in the next segment is we're going to be taking some phone calls. Now, I've got the number right here, and we're looking forward to taking your calls. We're going to take a little break right now, and I believe we're going to be looking at some internet sites. Thank you, and we'll see you shortly.